Hi, I'm Dr. Triveni Arun. I have done MD, MRCOG from UK in obstetrics and gynecology. I have an experience of 16 years in obstetrics and gynecology. Presently, I'm associated with Cloudnine, Sahakarnagar, Bangalore. Diagnosis of an ectopic pregnancy. Most of the time, the ectopic pregnancy is suspected between 6th to 10th week of the pregnancy. Sometimes the diagnosis is made quickly. And sometimes in early stages of the pregnancy, the diagnosis may take a little longer time. So when you meet a doctor, the doctor would ask your symptoms about your medical history, especially about your menstrual history, and they will ask you about your last menstrual period, following which they will examine you, they will do an abdominal examination and also examination from down below, that is a vaginal examination, to rule out the chances of an ectopic pregnancy. Then the next test which will help us in the diagnosis is the urine pregnancy test if you have not done earlier. If the urine pregnancy test comes negative, then the symptoms may not be related to an ectopic pregnancy. If it is positive, based on your symptoms, the further test will be advised. The next test would be to do an ultrasound scan. Mainly, we recommend to do a transvaginal scan, which is more accurate because the probe what is introduced from down below, that is through the vagina, is closer to the uterus, which helps us to locate the pregnancy in a better way. So sometimes in an early stages, the pregnancy may not be detected in the uterus. In that case, we may repeat an ultrasound scan after a few days. The other test which we commonly do is the when we are suspecting an ectopic pregnancy is the blood test. The blood test includes your complete blood count to check for the hemoglobin, and the other important blood test is to check for the pregnancy hormone level, that is the beta HCG. This hormone in a normal pregnancy will double every 48 hours. That is, the rise of the beta HCG hormone would be 63 to 65%. Every 48 hours in case of a normal pregnancy where the pregnancy is in the uterus. But in case of an ectopic pregnancy, the levels of beta HCG would be lower in the beginning and the rise may not be up to 63%, or sometimes the rise may be slower, or sometimes it may remain at the same level. So we have to be on a regular follow-up with the beta HCG. And for us to locate an ectopic pregnancy on the ultrasound scan, mainly through a vaginal scan, the level of beta HCG has to cross above 1000 to 1500 international unit. That is the time we will be able to locate the pregnancy wherever it is. Either it could be inside the uterus or it could be in the outside the uterus, like for example in the fallopian tube.